will prepare a process shape for this component. The component diagram is shown. It is having a final operation. The material for this job is brass bar, which having 25 mm diameter. And all these operations are performed on a single spindle automat, which is a semi-automatic machine. For this component, we are preparing a detailed process sheet, tool layout, and cam profile for drilling operation. Also, we are going to calculate a production rate per hour for this component. For calculating all these things, we require to follow some steps, in which first step is determination of machining element. Machining elements means these elements which are actually producing a chips. So whatever the process, machining process, are coming under these machining elements. So first we have to list down what are the different process which we have to perform on the raw job, so that we are getting a final product. Then we have to determine non-machining elements. Non-machining elements are those which are not actually producing a chips, but they are supporting the machining elements. So the non-machining elements are bar feeding, approach of the tool, indexing of turret, dwelling, and retracting of the tools. Then we have to determine the cycle time. This cycle time we have to calculate based on the machining elements and non-machining elements. Then we have to decide the operation sequence, in which operation sequence we have to perform the operation. And based on this operation sequence, we are designing a cam profile and tool layout for the slide and turret. So preparing this tool layout and cam profile and process sheet, first we have to bifurcate the operations which can be performed by the tools which are available on slide, and the tools which are the operations performed by the tools which are available on turret. For this, you have to understand these two motion. One is transverse motion and second one is longitudinal motion. Transverse motion is what? Which is the cutting edge of the tool is perpendicular to the workpiece axis. That is a transverse motion. And longitudinal motion, the cutting edge is parallel to the workpiece axis. That is a longitudinal motion. So operations are done by the tools which are available on slide. They are given the transverse motion, that is perpendicular to the workpiece axis. And operations are done by the tools on turret. They are given the longitudinal motion, means the cutting edge is perpendicular to the workpiece axis. The direction is shown by these arrows, perpendicular and parallel. So for this job, first we have to decide the machining elements. So the machining elements means the process which are performed on the job, so that we can get this final finished product. So whenever we are performing a process, we have to decide the tool travel, that is in mm. So first process is facing, that is given a transverse motion. So the facing is the foremost process. Whenever we are performing any operation on any job, first we are doing the facing operation. That is a first standard operation. Tool travel for this job for the facing is 12.5 mm. If you see, the diameter of this job is 25 mm and we are doing the facing operation at the center of this workpiece. So the center of this 25 mm is 12.5. So facing we are doing for the tool travel for 12.5 mm. Then next is central drill. Central drill we are doing so that whenever we are performing any operation where the tool we want to hold, for that purpose we are performing this central drill. And the tool travel is given as 4 mm. This standard value we are setting, that is 4 mm. Then turning to the outer diameter of 20 mm. So this is the 20 mm. We have to turn from this 25 mm tool travel up to 40 mm. This 30 plus 5 plus 5, that is 40 mm. We have to turn this job with the diameter of 20 mm. Then drilling with the diameter of 10 mm we have to perform, and this drilling operation is throughout. So if you see, the whole length of this job is for this 30 plus 5 plus 5 plus 10, that is 50 mm. If you perform the drill for this 50 mm, then tool point is coming at this position. So if we give the tool travel only 50 mm, then the tool cutting tool tip will rest at this position. So to remove all the materials which is at this position, we have to give a extra tool approach. So first 50 mm plus 2 mm extra tool approach we are given. So the tool travel for drilling is 52 mm. Then next operation is grooving. So grooving for this diameter 15, which is a 5 mm wide and 2.5 mm depth. Then fillet, this is an extreme end operation. This fillet that we are given 2.5 mm tool travel, that is a radius 2.5. Then last is parting off. Whenever you are performing all these 6 operations, you will get this finished product. Then we have to cut this job. For this we are using this parting off tool, so that we can cut the job apart and we can again extend the bar so that we can perform the next operation. So for this the tool travel is given 7.5 mm. Why is the 7.5? We seen the part of we are doing at the center, till the center, and we have already done the 10 mm drill hole. So whenever this part of tool is going from this direction, it is going up to this end. So that distance is 7.5 mm. Then non-machining elements. Non-machining elements are given the ideal degrees. So first bar feeding, this ideal degree is standard and it is constant, that is 9 degree. Then approach of the tool, that is 12 degree. Indexing, that is 12 degree. Whenever we are performing a turret operation, for every turret operation we have to give indexing, so that it can move backward and it can change the tools. So all these things they are done at this 12 degrees. Then dwell is given when operations are performed on a slide. So changing of a tool on slide, it can happen in this 2 degrees. So dwell is given as 2 degrees. Then retract of the tool, when all the operations are performed, you have to retract all the tools to the initial position. So that degrees are given as 12 degrees. Then we have to list down the operations which I have to perform. So whenever the operations we are listing down, we have to bifurcate all these operations based on the slide operation and turret operation. So first slide operation, that is a facing. Whenever that operation is given the transverse motion, that comes under this slide. So first is facing, then grooving, fillet and part off. So for all the operation, whatever the tools are used, they are given by this designation S1, S2, S3 and S4. If you see, this is the slide, the tools whichever attach, if you see, the S1 is for facing, S2 is for grooving, S3 for fillet and last S4 for part off. And we can change the slide position. Whenever one operation is performed, we can change the direction of slide in this way. Then next, operation done by tools on turret. So the whatever the tool is moving in longitudinal direction, that tools are attached on a turret. And the operations are performed, that is central drill, outer diameter turning and drilling. And the tool designation is given as T1, T2 and T3. And this turret is having a hexagonal shape. And this hexagonal shape, the six tools we can attach. But for this operation, we require only three tools. So these three tools are attached here with. So this is a T1, that is central drill, T2 outer diameter turning, and T3 is a drilling. And we can change the direction of turret based on the which operations we have to perform. So all the operations are given and the tool travel. And based on that, we have to prepare a process sheet. Process sheet is contains of 8 columns. And one by one, we are preparing this all 8 columns. So this is the extra column included, in which we can bifurcate the operations which are performed on by the tools which are available on turret, and the operations which are performed by the tools available on slide. So that we can easily understand and we can easily write in front of all these things. So first column is process or elements. So whatever the machining and non-machining elements, all these processes or elements are coming under this column. So first is bar feeding, then approach of the tool, and then we are listing down the operations which are performed on a turret. So that is a central drill. As I mentioned, whenever we complete every operation by using a tools on turret, we have to give indexing, that is a non-machining element, so that we can change the turret movement and we can change the tool for the next operation. So the next operation, outer diameter turning, then again indexing, then drilling, and then indexing. And for these all operations, the tool travel is given in mm. So for central drill is 4 mm, outer diameter turning is 40, drilling is 52 mm. Then operations which are done by the tools which are available on slide, that is the facing, grooving, and after done operation by using a slide, we are giving a dwell so that we can change the tools which are available on slide. So we can rotate. For this, we are giving the dwell. And after facing, we are not giving a dwell, because this dwell is given to increase the finish operation. So for every slide operation, we are giving the dwell, and the tool travel for every slide operation is given in a second column. So first column is for process and elements, which contains the non-machining elements and machining elements, and second column is a tool travel. So whenever we are listing down the processes and the tool travel, based on that we can easily plot these two columns, that is the first and second column. Then feed, that is a third column, that value we have to give in a mm per revolution, that we have to decide. So for every operations which are done by the tools on turret, we have to give the feed as 0.1 mm, because we have to remove more materials. So for getting a less cycle time, we are giving the feed maximum. And slide, we are giving the feed except facing for all the operation as 0.05. For facing, we are giving the feed as 0.1 mm. So first, these are the three columns. Then fourth column is machining revolution. We have to calculate the machining revolution. For this, we have to use one formula, that is a tool travel into 1 upon feed. So whatever the tool travel we are getting from this second column and the feed we are getting from the third column, using these two columns value, we can calculate the machining revolution, that is the fourth column value. So for example, I have given for the central drill, the tool travel is 4 mm and the feed is 0.1. So 4 into 1 upon 0.1, we are getting 40 revolutions. So in this way, we can calculate for all these operations, all these machining elements. So what all the value we are getting in of machining revolution, for center reel is 40, outer diameter turning is 400, drilling 520, facing 125, grooving 50, fillet 50 and part of 150. Then the next column is machining degrees and idle degrees. So whenever we want to calculate the machining degree, we require the idle degrees value, and these are the standard value for the non-machining element. So all these values are given in this sixth column, and for calculating this machining degree, we require the total of idle degrees and total of machining revolution. So machining degree we have to calculate by using this formula, that is a K into machining revolution. K is a factor, and that factor we can calculate by using this simple formula, that is 360 minus total of idle degree upon total of machining revolution. So this total of idle degree we are getting as 73, and total of machining revolution we are getting as 1335. So based on this value, we are getting a K factor, that is 0.2149. And by using this K factor and machining revolution value, we can calculate the machining degree for each machining elements. So for example, I given for central drill, that is K factor into machining revolution of central drill, that is 40. We are getting this 9 degree for a central drill. And whenever you are calculating machining degree for all the machining elements, we are getting some fraction value. So whenever that value point, if we are getting that is 8.5 value, then we know whenever that that value is 0.5 or more than 0.5, then we are getting a next number, and below 5 we are getting a earlier number. So we have to decide by using these formulas, we are getting the machining degrees values for all the elements. So for central drill, that is a 9 degree, outer diameter turning as 86 degree, drilling 111 degrees, facing 27 degrees, grooving 11 degrees, fillet 11 degrees and part of 32 degrees. So for calculating this total of machining degrees and idle degrees, you have to consider one circle, because when you add these two values, it should be a 360, because the cam is rotating in 360 value, that is completing its circle. So whenever it is not coming any value near to this 287 degrees, then we have to adjust in between these two values, so that this total of machining degrees and idle degrees, that will combine and we can get a 360 degree value. Then last two column is operation sequence and degree sequence. This operation sequence gives by using which sequence we are performing operation. So whenever we want to perform any operation on this single spindle automat, first we have to feed the bar. So this first operation will be a bar feeding, and second we have to approach all the tools to this initial position. So that will be the second operation. So these two operations are standard. First operation will be bar feeding, second will be approach of the tool. And when these operations are performed, then third will be the facing operation, because whenever we are getting a raw bar, first we are facing one side, so the third will be a facing. Then we are performing a central drill. Whenever we are performing a operation by using a turret tool, you have to give a indexing. So from when you complete a central drill, the next operation sequence for the indexing. then outer diameter turning, that is will be the 6th, and 7 will be the indexing, then 8 will be a drilling, 9 for the indexing. Then we are performing a slide operation, then grooving will be 10, then after grooving we are giving a dwell. So next operation sequence will be dwell, so that 11 is given for the dwell of grooving, 12 for fillet, and 13 for dwell of fillet. Then all the operations are performed, then we have to cut the job, so the last operation sequence will be the part of. Then based on this we have to calculate the last column value, that is a degree sequence. For this we required this machining degrees values column and ideal degrees values column, because we are drawing a cam profile which is from 0 to 360 degree. So first our cam will be start from 0 degree and it will get the value of 9 degree. It will approach from 0 to 9 degree, then from 9 degree the approach of the tool which is having a 12 degree, that 9 plus 12 we are getting 21 degree. Then third sequence of operation is facing, it will start from 21 degree and get the machining degrees values at 27, so 21 plus 27 we are getting 48 degree. Then fourth operation is 40 central drill, it will start from 48 degree which contains a machining degree from of 9 degree, so 48 plus 9 57. Then indexing start from 57 plus 12 degrees of ideal, that is 57 plus 12 69. Then outer diameter turning, sixth operation, 69 degree it will start, plus it will constrain a machining degree of 86, 69 plus 86 155 we are getting. Then when we done the operation of turning, then we have to give indexing, that is that of 12 degrees, so 155 plus 12 167 degrees. Then next operation sequence is drilling, it will start from 167 plus machining degree of 111, that is 167 plus 111 278. From this 278 the indexing plus 12 we are getting 290. Then operation sequence is next operation sequence is grooving, 290 plus 11 we are getting 301 plus 12, that is 301 plus 2 degree 12 we are getting 303 degree. Then operation sequence is fillet, it will start from 303 degree and we are getting, it will end at 314. Then dwell, 314 degree plus 2 we are getting 306 degree. Then last operation, that is a part of, it will start from 316 degree plus 32, that is 348 degree. So all the operations are done, then we have to retract all the tools, and which is having 12 degrees of ideal degree, so it will start from 348 degree to 360 degree. So whenever we are preparing a process sheet, see that whenever you are coming at this value, that is a tool retract, it always start from this 348 degree and it should end from 360 degree. So whenever it is not starting from 348 degree, so that you can change, you can check all this value with whatever you are getting, because this is a standard 12 degrees is given, so it has to start from 348 degree, which combines 12 degrees of ideal degree, and it should end up to 360 degree. So you have to end this degree sequence at 360 degrees. So next we have to calculate a production rate per hour for this component. So production rate per hour we can calculate by using this formula 3600 upon cycle time in seconds, and this cycle time we can calculate for the one component, that is total spindle revolution upon spindle speed. And spindle speed we can calculate by using the formula 1000 into V upon pi d. Pi d, d is the final diameter, that is 25 mm. And total spindle revolution we can calculate for the entire cycle based on the machining revolution and idle spindle revolution. The machining revolution value we are getting from this process sheet. So we required idle spindle revolution value. This idle spindle revolution we can calculate by using this formula, that is total of idle degrees upon total of machining degrees into total of machining revolution. So to calculate the spindle speed, we required this value of cutting speed. For this, there is one table we have to refer based on this workpiece material and the tools which you are using. Either you are using HSS tool or carbide tool. Based on this workpiece material, you can select the different values. So if you have seen the tool, workpiece material which are available or we are performing operation, that is a brass. So either you can select HSS or carbide, but this is a soft material, so we can select the hard tool. So we can select the HSS tool, which range of cutting speed from 80 to 120. So in between these two value, you can select any value for the cutting speed to calculate a spindle speed values. So one by one we can calculate all these value so that we can get final production rate per hour for this component. So first we have to calculate idle spindle revolution by using this formula, total of idle degree upon total of machining degree into total of machining revolution. So when you put all this value, you are getting idle spindle revolution as 340 revolutions. And total spindle revolution means what? Some total of machining revolution and idle spindle revolution. The machining revolution value you can get from the process sheet. That is a 1335 plus this 340 revolution, idle spindle revolution. So total spindle revolution we are getting, that is 1675 revolutions. Then spindle speed. In this, I selected the cutting speed value, that is 100. So in between this 80 to 120, you can select any value. So for this problem, I selected the cutting speed value as 100 meter per minute. So based on this, I got the spindle speed value, that is 1274 RPM. So based on this spindle speed value, I can calculate the cycle time for one component by using this formula, total spindle revolution upon spindle speed. Total spindle revolutions we are getting 1675 and spindle speed as 1274. Based on this, we are getting the cycle time for one component in minutes as 1.314 and in second, that is 78.88 seconds. So we can calculate the production rate per hour, that is 3600 upon 78.88, this value in second. So we can get 46 components fully finished in 1 hour. Then cam profile. So while drawing cam profile, we have to assume certain parameters. So first assumption is you have to select a shaft diameter. You can select any value. For this, I selected the shaft diameter as 20 mm. Then second is base circle diameter, that is 40 mm. So for this is the process, And this camp profile is only drawn for the operations which are done on a turret. So camp profile we are only drawing for a turret. So these are the machining elements are given for the turret. These two are standard, these are required, and all these center drill, outer diameter turning, drilling, these are the process or machining elements on turret. And we require these two columns value, that is tool travel and degree sequence, to prepare a cam profile. So that this is the shaft diameter of 20 mm, and for this shaft we are given the keyhole. Then this is the base circle diameter. So how much value the cam will rise, that is based on the maximum tool travel. So this maximum tool travel we have to draw from the end of this base circle, whatever the value. For this we are getting the maximum tool travel is 52. So from this point we have to draw one line to this 52 value. Then from you have to select this center and this much length as a radius, and you have to draw this outer circle. Means at this end the cam will rise. Then we have to draw all these degree values. First will be 9 degree, 21 degree, all the degrees value we have to draw. Once you complete all this, then you have to design a cam profile. So first is a central drill, which is starting from this 48 degree and ending at 57 degree, which I have given the tool travel as 4 mm. So from this point we have to draw plot 4 mm distance backward, and we have to take as this as a initial point, this as a initial point, and this as a end point, and this cam will rise from this starting point to this end point like this. So this is for central drill. Then next is outer diameter turning. So from this will start from 69 degree and it will end at 155 degree. So from this 69 degree you have to draw a line and you have to plot one point which is 40 mm distance. So this is the starting point, line is point drawn, this will be a starting point and this will be the end point. Then third is drilling, and that drilling point we have to plot, that is a 52 mm. So it will start from this base circle and it will start from this 167 degrees and it will end to this 278 degrees, that is 167 to 278. So this tool we have to rise from this for this center drill up to this point. So how it will start? It will start from this 0 degree, then first will be the bar pitting, it will start from this base circle, then approach of the tool. So how we are getting this point? So whatever the point we are getting while plotting this 4 mm distance, from this point to this point take as a center and mark this center at this point and draw a straight line. Because why I have drawn this straight line? In between this 21 degree to 48 degree the facing operation is performed, and if you guy move the turret up to this end, then what will happen? It will collide with the facing tool. So what we have to do? We have to move a turret in two position. So whenever it will, first it will start from this to this end, so the facing will complete, and the when the tool is retracting, then again we have to move the turret at this position, and then the operation, central drill operation, will perform. Then we have to change the tool so that we can get the outer diameter turning operation. So for that we have to give indexing. We are using a semi-automatic machine, so we are not directly joining from this point to this point. We are not giving a rapid transfers. For this, what we are doing, from this 57 to 67 degrees, we are getting a taking a center, and from this center point up to this center point, from this point we are joining drawing one line, and this point to this point we are joining line in a straight, so that we are, instead of rapid transfers, we are giving a intermittent motion. For this, when you complete outer derming, then indexing, similar, instead of rapid transfers, we are giving the indexing up to this point, center of this 155 degree and 167. Same here, 278 to 290, that is the indexing after the drilling at the center point. Then this tool will go to the initial position, that is a tool retract. All this tool will go to this position, and we can get this cam profile. So this cam profile is for all these operation, that is a central drill, outer diameter turning, and drilling. This is a tool layout for turret. So this is a hexagonal turret which are showing all the tools, that is central drill, drill, and outer diameter turning tool. This hexagonal is having a side of 30 mm. This is the R1. This R1 value is what? 30 mm hexagonal side plus 4 mm tool travel of this central drill. So R1 will be 30 plus 4, that is 34 mm. Then second circle is for outer diameter turning, and the R2 value is what? 30 hexagonal side plus 40, that is a tool travel of this outer diameter running. So R2 we are getting as 70 mm. Then third is drilling. This R3 value is what? 30 plus 52 mm tool travel is equal to 82 mm. So for this tool layout, we are getting this R1, R2 and R3 value. R1 has 34 mm, R2 70 mm, R3 82 mm. Then tool layout for slide. Suppose this is the diameter of the workpiece, then you have to divide this circle in any points. We can divide this circle in any number of parts based on the how much tools which are available on slide, and we have to give a rotation. Based on this rotation, we can change the cutting edge of this tools which are available on slide. So that will be the first tool, that is S1. It is for facing. This is the cutting edge. So whenever the tool is moving in direction, the tool tip will act and the chip will remove in this direction. So this S1 is for facing, S2 is for grooving, S3 is for fillet, one tool we are keeping a vacant, and after that we are adding a part of tool. Why we are putting this in vacant position? Because if suppose the job drawing is changed, so that we can add any extra tool if it is required. So this is the tool layout for this slide. If you see, we are not combining any operation, we are performing all the operation one by one, so that we are getting a less production rate and maximum cycle time. If you want to reduce a cycle time and if you want to increase a production rate, we have to combine the operation. Which operation will combine? We can combine the turret operation with the slide operation. If you have seen the process sheet, this turret operation, which is a drilling of diameter 10 mm, we can combine with the slide operation. So turret operation, there are four operations, that is a central drill, turning and drilling, three operation. And slide, there are four operation, that is facing, grooving, fillet and part out. If you see, we can't combine the facing operation with this drilling operation, because whenever we are doing a facing operation, we can't do a drilling operation, it will collide. Then next, the central drill. For this central drill also, we can combine these two operations, because the machining revolution for the central drill is less as compared to this machining revolution of grooving and fillet. Then outer diameter turning, for this also we can combine these two operations, slide operation, because these two are external operation, external surface operation. So first we have to turn the job, then and then only we can perform this grooving and fillet. So we can't combine with turning operation. So the last operation, that is a drilling. Drilling is an internal operation, and this grooving and fillet are external surface operation. So whenever the drilling is performing, we can perform this grooving and fillet on external surface. So this drilling we can combine with grooving and fillet. So this process sheet, which it is for combining operation. So we can see, for the drilling, it is combined with this grooving and fillet. So whenever we are combining all the this slide operation with this drilling, with these tools which are available on turret, whatever the machining revolution we are not considering, because all these machining revolutions are coming with this drilling operation. So we are not considering these two slides machining revolution, that is grooving and fillet. So we are deducting this machining revolution value from this total. So we are getting a total machining revolution as 1235, that is a new machining revolution. Same, whatever the machining degrees value also we are not considering, and idle degrees value. So from this we are deducting all this value. From this we are getting a new idle degree value as 69 degree. So whenever we are getting the machining degrees values, new machining degrees values and new ideal degrees value, based on that we can calculate new machining degrees values. So based earlier we have seen the formulas, based on this we can calculate the new machining degrees values. Make sure that the addition of this machining degrees and ideal degree should be 360 degree. If it is not coming, then you can alter somewhat 1 to 2 degrees all this value. Then you can see the operation sequence is changed. for after the 7, that is indexing after the outer diameter turning, the next operation sequence is drilling. And whenever the drilling is performing, we are performing the grooving and fillet. So the same operation sequence is given for the grooving and fillet. That is 8 for drilling, 8 dash for grooving. And again we are changing the tool, so we have to give a dwell. So we are giving the next operation sequence, that is 8 dash for the dwell of grooving, 8 double dash for dwell of grooving, 8 dash for fillet, 8 double dash for dwell of fillet. Then all the operation is performed, then next operation sequence is indexing of drilling, then we are getting a product finished, then last operation sequence is part of. We see the values of these two columns, machining degree and idle degree, are changed. So the values for this degree sequence will also change. We are getting a new degree sequence value. Up to this we are getting the same values, but here if we see, we are getting a new machining degrees value for facing. So we can change this value, and by using addition, this idle degrees and machining degree, we are getting this degree sequence column. And next, if we are combining the operations, can we get the change in production rate per hour? So these are the formulas for calculate a production rate per hour. So idle spindle revolution, the values for total idle degrees and machining degrees and machining revolution are changed. So based on these new values, we are getting a new idle spindle revolution as 293 revolutions. Total spindle revolution for entire cycle, that is a change in the value of machining revolution, idle spindle revolution, we are getting a total spindle revolution as 1528, that is a new value. The spindle speed we are getting a same, because we are not changed this cutting speed value, so that value will be remain same. Then cycle time for one component, we are changed, we are getting a new value of this total spindle revolution. So cycle time will change to new value as 1.19 minute and 71.96 second. Earlier we are getting 78.88 second. So the cycle time is reduced. So once you reduce the cycle time, we can change, we are getting a production rate higher, that is 50 components. So earlier when we are not combining operations, we are getting 46 components produced in a 1 hour. Here we are getting 50 components produced in 1 hour. So 4 components extra we can produce in 1 hour when we are combining the operation. Then next, cam profile for turret. In this, extra assumptions we are making, that is that we are adding a tool resting circle diameter, because we are only drawing this cam profile for drilling operations. So we have to rest all the tools on this tool resting circle, so only one circle we have added. This is the process sheet for which we are drawing a cam profile. See, drilling, which is combined with this grooving fillet. So this is the shaft diameter, this is a tool retract, maximum tool travel, and this is a shaft diameter, that is a tool resting circle, and this is a base circle. From this base circle we have to draw one line and we have to point a maximum tool travel distance, that is 52, and taking this as a center and this much distance as a radius, we have to draw a outer circle. Then all degrees value we have to plot, 9 degree for bar feeding, 9 to 21 for approach of the tool, 177 at this degree the drilling will start and it will end up to 301 degree, and then indexing up to 330 degree, then retract of the tool will start from 348 to 360 degree. See the drilling operation, it will start from 177 and it end at 301 degree. The cam rise, cam whatever we are drawing, we seen the tool bar feed will start from this 9 degree, the tool is resting, so we are approaching the tool to this base circle, so from this tool resting it is approached to this base circle, then they are changed up to this, or it will move from this 177 degrees, so from this the drilling operation is performed up to 301 degree, then indexing, then all the tools which are coming it will move up to 348 degree. Then we have to retract all the tools, so this tool retract we start from this base circle and it will end at this tool resting circle. So in this way we are getting the cam profile only for drilling operation. Then tool layout for turret, hexagonal offside 30 mm, this is the R1 for central drilling, 30 plus 4, 34 mm, this is the R2, 30 plus 40, that is 70 mm, then R3, 30 plus 52 mm is equal to 82 mm, so this is the tool layout for turret. Then tool layout for slide, so whatever earlier we have seen, same we have to draw a tool layout for slide. S1 for facing, S2 for grooving, S3 for fillet, vacant we are keeping for if any operation is added, and last is part of. Thank you. We have seen how to prepare a process sheet for any component. We have seen the different steps we have to follow, and based on these different steps we can prepare a process sheet. Then we have seen a cam profile for all the operations which are performed on turret and only for drilling operation. And whatever the change in production rate per hour, if we perform all the operation in by using a single pass, and if we combine both the operation, that is a turret operation and slide operation, how the change in production rate will take place, that we have seen. Then tool layout for turret and slide, how to draw this tool layout, we have seen. So whatever the things it is required to draw a process sheet that we have seen in this video. If you like the video, please stay connected for the further videos. Thank you.